With the Xbox Series X gameplay reveal stream behind us, it's time to look to the future for July in the Xbox Game Studio reveal stream. In this video, I'm going to give you the 10 things to expect for Halo Infinite. Stay tuned throughout the whole video to understand all the details. How's it going, everybody? It's Kevin here once again, giving you another news informational video when it comes to Halo. If you like these kind of videos, please make sure to tap that like button as it greatly helps out the video and channel, gets more people to know, and also get the hype going for Halo Infinite as we're going to get a big reveal coming in July. Like I stated at the top of this video, we recently had the Xbox Series X gameplay reveal stream, and it left a lot to be desired from the community. As we can see, the current like to dislike ratio is about 40-ish% liked this stream. Certainly not numbers you would like to see when it comes to your community, and especially when you're saying gameplay reveals, people are expecting actual hands-on in-game at the moment gameplay, not gameplay reveal trailers, as we did get with this. Now, I do feel the July reveal will be something a little different, as it's going to be in-house Microsoft Game Studios, so they can have more access and be able to show more than their third-party games that they were showing, which are very much, you know, their own thing. Which obviously makes me think, what are we going to see for Halo Infinite in July? Well, what I want to do in this video is take a look in the past of what we saw last E3 reveal for a new Halo game, which was Halo 5, compared it to what to see for expectations for July coming around here. Now, a big issue with this that I'm seeing forward when it comes to this Xbox reveal is that it's going to be pretty tough to see live gameplay. I'm pretty much assuming that we're going to be seeing some
pre-recorded bullshit.
As Sergeant Johnson put it so lightly, due to the technical limitations of trying to host an entire event from home on live streams, I'm pretty sure what we will see is some kind of pre-recorded gameplay to at least show something. So, understanding the past of Halo 5's reveal, we can look forward to the future of the 10 things to look forward to with the reveal in July of Halo Infinite. As Halo Infinite is basically going to be the flagship game for the Xbox Series X, we know we will definitely going to be seeing some hardware graphical showcase. They're going to be showcasing probably some lighting, the environments, just the visual fidelity that can be captured with this game. And from what we've seen from the announcement trailer and the Discover Hope trailer, that the graphics look to be pretty dang great. With the Xbox Series X saying it's going to be 4K capable with 120 frames and all these other kind of specs, I'm sure we're going to be showcasing some hardware aspects of the game right there. Number two on this list, I think we're going to be seeing some story basics and setting. And what I mean by that is kind of similar to what we saw with Halo 5, is they basically just mentioned Master Chief is out on his own. He's gone AWOL. And then we have Locke is going to go hunt him down. Basic story information like that. Probably also mentioned the setting, as it seems like the environment has been a rather big emphasis, especially with the announcement trailer that Zeta Halo seems to be the rumored location for this game to be taking place on. Number three on this list, kind of explaining that a little bit in greater detail, I have a feeling what we will be seeing some pre-recorded gameplay of a campaign mission, maybe something more in the middle of the run kind of stuff, maybe nothing, anything really showcasing any kind of story aspects or anything like that. I think we'll see something rather similar to the Jedi Fallen Order reveal, which we saw was rather kind of run-of-the-mill mundane kind of gameplay, but it kind of gives you the meat and potatoes of what you're going to be doing for the most of the game. And obviously everyone was kind of concerned about that reveal, and then later on when the game actually came out, it was very well received, and the rumors are that they're actually going to be making a sequel to that game. Now in Halo 5, we did have a villain reveal, which I think will probably get a similar kind of thing for point number four, is a villain reveal. Like I mentioned earlier, it seems like the Banished will be returning in Halo Infinite. From all the leaks that we've seen, it pretty much almost confirms, without actually officially being confirmed, that the Banished will be returning. You can't show the Banished without showing Atriox. That we'll get a very basic showing of him and what he's there to do and what we're going to decide to stop him from doing, basically. With number five on this list, I'm assuming we'll see some new abilities or some new kind of attributes to Master Chief in the game. Much like we saw with Halo 5's E3 reveal, we saw Boost, Clamber, and Ground Pound, and the Artemis Tracker all being used within the same gameplay. I'm assuming we'll have something kind of showcased as well. Now, there is no leaks or really anything to kind of substantial to talk about when it comes to the gameplay of Halo Infinite. I'm pretty sure we will only get some leaks probably just before the July announcement reveal. I've seen some unsubstantiated kind of rumors talking about how it may be a more open world kind of game, and in that case, bringing back the Artemis Tracker would actually be a pretty awesome way to help explore these environments. As in Halo 5, it was very scripted. I basically never use it unless the game made me do it. So I would like to see maybe that expanded on if it's going to be much more emphasis on exploration, which does kind of seem like what 343 has mentioned previously about they want to bring back that aspect of discovery and the wonder when it comes to Halo, which obviously something like exploring different environments could definitely be expanded on with the Halo Infinite. Number 6 on this list of what to expect for Halo Infinite's reveal, I'm assuming we'll see some old weapons return, which we've already seen the Battle Rifle and the Halo Reach Assault Rifle within the trailers, but I'm assuming we'll see some new weapons as those always generate a lot of excitement, a lot of things to talk about when it comes to the game, because you want to showcase the new stuff coming to the game to give people reason why to buy this one. With the Halo 5 reveal trailer, we did see the Plasma Caster as a new weapon, but we did see the return of like the Battle Rifle, the Shotgun, Plasma Pistol, things like that. Number 7, I'm assuming we'll also see some new characters. We already know about the pilot from the Discover Hope trailer, and from what we've heard from different leaks and rumors that he will be a character throughout the game, and so I would assume that we might see some new faces and some returning ones as well. We do know that at least with the book that's releasing a few months before Halo Infinite, the book Shadows of Reach does show Master Chief with his new armor set along with Kelly, Linda, and Fred as well, so maybe those characters will be returning. Again, that's not confirmed, but I'm just kind of speculating on that one. Number 8 on the list, I'm assuming we will see some returning and some new enemy types. As I did mention, that we probably will see the Banished, as the Banished have never been in a mainline shooter game, only in Halo Wars 2, so we could probably see some more aspects of that. We also see some returning enemy types. I'm highly suspecting that we will see the Flood return in this game, so maybe some new Flood forms even on top of that. Some returning enemy types like the typical Covenant enemies that we've fought in previous Halo games as well, so it has some familiarity with the game as well as something new. Number 9 on the list, I'm assuming we'll also see very similar new and old returning vehicles, as we do know the Warthog is going to be returning, as we saw from the Halo Infinite announcement trailer. We do know the Pelican is returning, as it was showcased in the Discover Hope trailer as well. A different little bit of a model, but obviously it'll be returning. We did see in Halo 5 reveal trailer in E3, they showcased a new vehicle like the Phaeton coming in, so I'm assuming we'll see some new stuff on top of that. And to round off the list, number 10, multiplayer reveal. Now this one does seem rather up in the air what we will see. Now we do know that they've had a playable build of Halo Infinite December of 2018, as mentioned in a previous live stream from 343, that they did a in-house kind of tournament game using Halo Infinite. So obviously I'm sure things have changed since then. Now given the extended development time this game has had, we might have to get a chance to show more of the game, or it might be kind of more what we saw with Warzone's reveal at the Halo 5's announcement of at E3, that it was more just kind of a highlight reel showcasing the very basics of things and stuff like that. This also just depend on whether or not we will get some flighting process information. S343 has stated they do plan to do a flighting process for Halo Infinite. Now, my assumption that the game will be announced for a release date in November, that would only give roughly about 4 months of flighting to get a chance for the community to give some feedback. Though much like the previous reveals of the announcement and Discover Hope trailer, that we had a blog on Halo Waypoint going in greater detail about certain things about Halo, depending on whether or not it be about the multiplayer or campaign or certain kind of features like Forge, Theater, Split Screen, things like that. Personally, I would like 343 to not announce the flighting process during the live show, as it will probably attract a lot of people who would rather just want to jump in and play the game first and have that experience, rather than actually be able to give constructive feedback like the community would. But there are so many directions the multiplayer could go full classic, could go sticking with modern, could be blending the two together, which seems to be the general trend of Halo Infinite. It's really kind of up to see what's going to be happening. Obviously with multiplayer aside of shooters nowadays, it's a much more malleable, if you will, that they're always constantly changing and evolving and improving. And I think we'll see something very similar with the multiplayer reveals. They won't get maybe full-on gameplay, but probably highlights, screenshots, highlight reels, things like that. And lastly, to end everything off, I think we will get a release date announcement as well. I'm assuming sometime in November, as every Xbox console has released in November. I'm assuming probably a week or two before Black Friday, and that's when the release time of this game will be. So those are the 10 things to look out for with Halo Infinite's reveal coming in July for the Xbox Game Studios reveal. So what is the number one thing you expect to see for Halo Infinite or want to see for Halo Infinite's reveal in July? Let me know in the comment section down below. I do read all the comments and try to reply to most of them as well. Hopefully Microsoft has learned their mistakes with the Xbox Series X gameplay reveal that they did, as the community did not really appreciate the misleading of that. As for the streams in July, I will live stream it for you guys on this channel and on my Twitch. We usually do a viewing party, and oftentimes I reclip out my reaction videos. So if you want to be part of the content on this channel, guys, make sure you subscribe and follow on Twitch as well to keep yourselves updated whenever we do that live stream. Make sure you tap subscribe to keep yourself updated with everything going on with Halo. And if you're new to the channel or missing any content from me recently, check out the videos on the screen right now. I got a link to my playlist that has all my news, information, and videos if you've been out of the loop for the last few days or so. So thank you so much for watching. I greatly appreciate it, and I'll catch you all in the next one. Peace out.